Good morning, good morning, good morning. Once again, we are back on the same topic. What prevents us from getting positive results from spiritual practices? But before then, we've already talked about it, and I have given an example. So this is the part two of the previous teachings. This is the episode two of our previous teachings. But before I delve into the episode two, first I seek protection from the divine source, from the universe into your life. I ask the universe to protect you and guide you. I ask blessings from the universe into your life. May your life never be the same. I ask the universe to open doors, to create opportunity in your life. May the universe protect you. May the divine source protect you and guide you. And bless you with riches abundantly. Okay. Our first episode on this topic, what prevents us from getting positive results through spiritual practices. I did give an examples and the scenarios of you being initiated to your ancestors, you know, or to your, you know, to a former gods before you saw Christ and you converted from that religion or from that faith to the new faith, or you left the other faith into Islam. There are things you have to know and understand. Being initiated to a higher being, okay, a higher being, it's an agreement between you and that being, okay. If the agreement took place from your forefathers, I said it earlier in our first video, because of the bloodline in which you came from, okay, you would surely inherit the agreement which had took place before your birth, okay. If the agreement was for them to protect them, to protect their family, to protect their bloodline, and bless them with riches, you would surely inherit that agreement, okay. So many a time, they left that faith without any proper check, without any consultation. They left that faith, and God, you know, or initiate themselves in a different faith. Okay, some of these practices, Christianity and Islam, Hindu, Buddhism, although Hindu is not specifically a religion, okay, it is a culture. They have their spiritual leaders, their spiritual masters, okay, in which if you are lucky enough and you meet those masters, if they are going to initiate you into that faith, okay, there are due to their spiritual capability, okay, when they initiate you indirectly, they cut the link that is between you and the former faith and the former agreement that was taken or was taken in place through your forefathers, your ancestors, okay. But what if you are not lucky enough? There is not everyone who is lucky to have that opportunity to meet such people before their initiation. Okay, either you like it or not. Okay, since you live your life on beliefs, you live your life on faith, either you know or not, you are being initiated to a certain spirit or to a certain being. Okay, so if the initiation took place, you became one of the devotee, one of the practitioners of that faith, you will surely have more connection due to your practices, due to your efforts and things that you do day in, day out. You surely have positive results, but these positive results will only be effective when there is no any agreement between you and any other God. There is no any agreement between you and any other God. Fine. Let me come to our brothers, the Christian aspects. You see, there is a quote in the Bible which says, let's make man in our own image and likeness. Okay, it is God who was asking a certain beings that they should make man in their own image and likeness. Some of the pastors do explain this as angels, but what I want you to know, the angels does not represent God, and they don't have the look alike of God, and they don't look like God, and they can never look like God. So if God is referring this as let's make a man in our own image and likeness, what image is God talking about? What likeness was God talking about? It means if God is God and he is talking to an entity or to an spiritual beings that let's make man in our own image and likeness, it means those that he was confronting or those that he was consulting, they are also like him. So they are also gods. So if they are also gods, so he was talking to his fellow gods that they should come together and make man in their own image and likeness. This, I'm talking on the perspective of Christianity, okay? So it means you are human, you are God on earth, you are God yourself on earth, a miraculous God on earth. So in the Quran, there is a verse that says, وَذْكَالَتْ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَائِرُ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً. When your God, when God was talking to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, when your God was about to represent or to put his represent, his vice president on earth, when he was about to represent his vice on earth, he consulted the angels, okay, that I am about to replace my representative on earth, okay, my vice on earth. And the angels were sabotaging. Do you want to create someone who is going to cause confusion, kill themselves, shed blood on the earth? Okay. So, and God say, "Inni a'lamu ta'lamu, verily I know what you do not know." Okay, so God was telling the angels he knows what they do not know. So in the end, Quran says, "Wa'allama Adama asma'a kullaha." Verily, God taught Adam all kinds of knowledge and experience and wisdoms, and all kinds of name, that which is in existence. God taught Adam everything. Okay, so God placed Adam, God, you know, bring Adam, and he brought the angels, you know, to debate. Okay, they should, you know, exhale their knowledge. They should bring their knowledge out, so that Adam too will bring his own knowledge out. So God asked them, "If you are knowledgeable, if you are claiming you know everything, and be only as my haula in Qudus Alikina, name the names of these things. I mean, name the names of creation, everything that which is in the creation, name it to me." And they couldn't. Okay, so it was Adam who named everything to them. So this is simply telling you that you are God on earth. You are God on earth. So lack of knowing ourselves, understanding the faculties in which is representing as this body, we went via to had an agreement with a different beings, which we see them in a higher position than we do. So this agreement was taking place, and we later, you know, realized that we are not on the right path, so we are deviating. I wouldn't say we are diverting, we are deviating from the other path to be initiated in a different path. So we couldn't separate ourselves, we couldn't disconnect the link from us to the other gods, and we got ourselves into a different initiation. So whenever you are practicing magic, the power that is within you, which has to flow naturally, okay, some people do practice magic on a natural point, natural aspect, okay, without tapping anything from any source. And there are people who practice magic through entities, okay, they need to tap their energy from a certain entities, okay. So if you are tapping your energy through entities, okay, these entities that you are tapping your energy from, definitely it's either they are having a relationship between them and the gods which you had an agreement with previously before you left the other place to this place. So if there is a relationship between them, okay, you are lucky, because things may go on smooth for you. But if there is no any, you know, sort of relationship between them, there is kind of dislikeness, there's kind of confusion between them, okay, if they are opposite to each other, definitely whenever you try to perceive spiritual spiritual results, the other God will surely intervene in your life and put stop to whatever must happen to you in terms of positivity or negative, whatever. And at times, they do not intervene when practicing magic, but they rather blocks the chances of, you know, winning in life, the chances of gaining better life, the chances of having smooth life. Okay, so you see yourself that you are praying, you are worshiping, you are servicing, you do whatever you know that this is what you have to do. You keep on doing it, but yet nothing is happening. Nothing will happen because the initial agreement in which your forefathers took place before your birth, you did not follow the rules. The rules and the regulation too was abandoned. The agreement was left behind. You abandoned them and you went in for another God without disconnecting and giving them the maximum respect. Okay? So definitely, they will be distracting your life. They will surely distract your life. Not that the new God that you serve, not that that God is not strong enough. The God is more stronger enough. But it depends on the one who initiates you. You see, in terms of faith, we do think that anyone can initiate you. Anyone or anybody can be an initiator. No, it is not anybody can initiate anyone. Okay? In Islam, we don't think that if you are only Muslim, you pray 5 daily salat, you can initiate someone. Okay? That is what has been said. Yes, literally, you can initiate anybody because you are entitled to do so as a Muslim. But spiritually, you are not. Initiating someone, it means you are cleansing someone's sin. You are cleansing the darkness in which has covered someone's life. You are bringing light into his life. Okay, you are thinking, you are projecting his astral and mental and celestial body from the physical body. You are trying, you are uplifting, you are raising him high into the astral peak of level. So if you don't know the spiritual aspect, the esoteric aspect of your religion, it will be very hard for you to be able to catch the link which is between that fellow and the boss. So you see that the person claims to be a Muslim, but still suffering still goes on. The person claims to be Christian, still suffering goes on. The person claims he is traditionalist, but still suffering still goes on, because 90% of believers, of practitioners, they do practice their faith ignorantly. As I'm talking to you, if I am an error, okay, I am an error, and I believe in traditional religion, and my hometown, my clan, aside from my hometown, my clan, we have the God that we serve, okay, and I didn't go to him for help, I didn't ask him for help, and I left him, and go for another God, okay, in a different clan or in a different tribe. means I left these beliefs. I left my belief. I have left my tradition. I have left that which is me. Okay? With no respect. With no honor. And go for another. You know, belief. Another tradition. Another family. Seeking for help. Psychologically, indirectly, I am telling my gods in which they are in my clan, my gods, that they are not powerful enough to give me what I'm seeking. So they will surely teach me a lesson. Maybe not today, but maybe tomorrow. They will surely teach me a lesson. Yes. So what I'm trying to say here is, if you are into something, make sure you put your mind, your heart, your love, your spirit, your soul into it. Put everything that has to be with you, or everything that had to do with you, make sure you put it in it. Do not be hypocrites whenever practicing something in terms of spirituality. If it is the gods, it is the gods that is in your family you believe in, serve them sincerely. If you believe there is a creator up there, serve him willingly. Serve him with passion. If you believe that you serve in the Mother Earth, believe in her, serve her willingly, dedicate your life for her. Okay? If you believe in the God of Fire, serve him. Whatever you believe in, I'm not here to condemn your belief. No. I'm not here to condemn your belief, but I'm here to unfold your belief system to you and know how best to go about it, how best to practice your belief system. In our next video, I will teach you how to disconnect yourself from a God to be initiated in a different faith. How to disconnect if you are in a society, maybe let's say Amok or like an Ekanka, okay, or Freemason or Guru Maharaji, whatever, or you are in a traditional belief system, or you are a Christian, you are a Muslim, whatever. How to disconnect yourself from that to the new faith that you got yourself into. Let me tell you something. If you are sick, when you are sick, and you add two medicines, two drugs at the same time, and you swallow, after taking two drugs without being prescribed by any professional medical doctor, what do you think it will happen to you? It's a drug abuse. Okay, it's a drug abuse. So, this is medical indigestion. So, spiritually, we have spiritual indigestion. Okay, we have spiritual indigestion. We add two energies together, two force together. Okay, in which you don't even understand the energy, you don't even understand what you are doing, you are not conscious about it. You will have spiritual indigestion, like the way you will have drug abuse or medical indigestion. So I will teach you how to disconnect the link between you and your fourth, father's faith since you are a Christian now, you need to disconnect yourself from the other faith, so that this new faith that you are practicing, you have full access and full communication and full resource. When you pray to God, He will answer your prayers instantly. God always listens to our prayers. Whenever you ask Him, whenever you call upon Him, He listens to your prayers. But because of the covenant which is between you and the other gods, so the prayers, the resource delays, you will cast a spell. You will not have positive resource, because when the energy that is in you is about to come out, or where you tap your energy, if you are tapping your energy from somewhere, that place that you are tapping your energy, the other place that you left with not respect, without being faithful servant, or without treating them well, they will make sure they will block the energy from flowing. They will block the other parts from doing their duties as your boss. That's it. So I will teach you how to do that, and also I'll give you the concept of Trinity, in which it is in all religion. Muslims, they have their Trinity, they have their concept of Trinity, they have their beliefs and they have their doctrines on that aspect, or on that Trinity. Christians have their Trinities, traditionalists have their Trinities, Judaic have their Trinities. Each and every faith on earth have their Trinity. They have their Trinity. So, but it depends on their explanations, the concepts, their concept on that Trinity. Okay? So, expect us in our new episode, that is episode 3. Episode 3. But the topic will be how to disconnect yourself from the gods. How to disconnect yourself from your former gods and connect yourself to your new God. Yes, how to disconnect yourself from the former gods and connect yourself from the new gods. I will leave you here. Expect us very soon. Shalom.
Okay.